Today, I'm going to show you how to use LTX2 video to generate videos using start and end frames. But we're not just going to toss you a basic workflow and call it a day. We've broken this down into four specific scenarios to teach you how to meticulously control the effects of your start to end frame generation. Scenario one involves two completely different scenes. Even if the start and end frames have absolutely no similarity other than the main character, we can still achieve a very impressive video generation result. Scenario 2 is when the start and end frames look somewhat related. Take a look at these examples. The focus here is on perspective changes. One video shows a beauty interacting with a stone lion, and the other shows her walking on a path in front of a palace. These types of videos turn out to be very distinctive. Scenario 3 is the one you are likely most familiar with, where the correlation between the start and end frames is extremely strong. In this case, we typically get a very high quality continuous one-shot video effect. Scenario 4 is a bit more complex. This is where the start and end frames look related, but actually contain significant discrepancies. In this situation, we usually end up with a video that looks like it has a scene transition or a cut. Once you understand the underlying mechanisms of these four scenarios, you will fully master the fundamental techniques of start end frame video generation in LTX2. To enable the start end frame function for LTX2, you need to install a ComfUI extension. This extension comes from the community expert TT Planet Pig. They recently released an update that adds LTX2 start end frame functionality. The mechanism here is quite easy to understand. It's a bit similar to the vase first frame to last frame node. We need to define the latents for the start and end frames, as well as their masks, to tell the model exactly which frames it needs to generate. Regarding installation, you can use ComfUI Manager or manually clone the repository. We recommend manual installation. You can find three basic LTX2 workflows in his release. But today we will focus on the start end frame version. Now, let's break down exactly how you should generate these videos based on the different scenarios. As always, I built this workflow on Running Hub, so you can access the platform directly in the ComfUI space. Running Hub is a fantastic online workbench because they follow up immediately whenever new models or extensions appear. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description to get 1,000 free credits. Plus, you get an extra 100 credits gifted every day you log in, so you can easily test your own workflows. Let's look at the first scenario. The start and end frames are completely unrelated. Look at these reference images generated in my previous video. They show a beauty touring the Forbidden City. These two images are totally distinct. One is a close-up in front of a palace, and the other is an interaction with a stone lion. If you want to use these two to generate a start end frame video, and you don't want a hard scene cut, the final effect looks like this. She walks from the front of the palace all the way to the stone lion. Since the video is only 5 seconds long, the progression feels like a fast-forward effect. To achieve this, you need to make two adjustments. First, the workflow, I added another reference image loader here. We resize the long edge to 1536 and then compress it. This process is identical to the image-to-video method, except one connects to the start frame and the other to the end frame. Then, we replace the original node with a new start-end control node. The original image-to-video node only controlled the start frame. We also need to swap the node used during the upscaling step. Second, pay attention to the prompt. If your prompt doesn't clearly explain how to switch between these two frames, you'll likely get a hard cut or a transition effect rather than a continuous shot. I suggest using the prompt generator I shared in the last lesson. I programmed a prompt engineering setup for this. You upload both images. Write a short system instruction telling it that image 1 is the start and image 2 is the end, and it will generate the final prompt you need. Paste that into your workflow, and you'll get the smooth result I showed you. Now for the second scenario, I call this looks related, but actually not that related. For example, look at this scene. Both images show the beauty touching the stone lion. However, the first image is an overhead high angle view, while the second image is an eye level view. Ultimately, apart from the main subject being similar, the rest of the content doesn't align well. We can use the same method using the prompt generator to create the corresponding prompt, and we can still get a very good result. Let's test another one. Similarly, in this case, the first image is a slightly high-angle view, and it is a long shot, wide shot, showing the beauty walking on the stone path in front of the palace. While this is the same scene, you'll notice that aside from the subject, the correlation is low due to the drastic perspective shift. We use the prompt generator to create the prompt again, and let's look at the final result. Take a look. The effect is very beautiful. So if you have a video with significant perspective changes, where the shift is quite drastic, you can still choose our prompt generator to help you create that start-to-end frame prompt, ensuring a fantastic video result. Scenario 3 is what you are likely most familiar with. Let's look at these two images. As start and end frames, they align almost perfectly. The only change is that the beauty moves from the side of the car to sitting on the hood. In this specific situation, we do not suggest using the prompt generator. Why? Because the prompt generator creates a prompt that covers the entire image. For example, it won't just describe how the character moves. It will describe how the waves move, how the camera moves, etc. The content becomes too dense. For images with such high correlation, this extra detail actually becomes a distraction or noise. If you believe your two images have very strong similarity, we recommend keeping your prompt very simple. For instance, my prompt here is simply a continuous shot. The girl slowly walks to the front of the car and sits on it. Let's look at the final generated result. The girl follows the requirements of my prompt perfectly and performs the corresponding action. Let's look at the final scenario. This is where two images look highly related, but contain many unrelated factors. Take a look at these two images. Besides the beauty's position changing, the camera angle has shifted slightly, but beyond that, notice the shape of the waves. Notice the position of the sun. They are different. How did we get two images like this? I generated these using QWImage text-to-image. First, I generated the first image. Then, when generating the second image, I kept the entire subject description, environment description, and character description exactly the same. I only modified the prompt regarding the character's position relative to the car, changing it from standing beside the car to sitting on the hood. At this point, we get two images that visually feel very similar. However, because they were generated by modifying the text prompt, text to image, many details are inherently different. Compare this to the images in scenario 3, which were generated using QWN image edit, image to image. In that case, I used the first image to generate the second, simply telling the prompt to change the beauty's position. That method ensures the pixels align. Therefore, if you only use QWN image text to image to modify prompts, the images might look alike, but the details are different. In this case, no matter how you write the prompt, the result will almost always look like a camera cut or scene switch. Why? Because the model doesn't have enough room to play. Most pixels seem aligned, but individual elements differ, so it cannot smoothly transition. It has to force a cut. And that covers the four scenarios. Fundamentally, it comes down to this. The method you use to generate your images determines the correlation between them. The correlation of the images then dictates what kind of prompt you should write. And finally, understanding this allows you to predict in advance whether your start-end frame video will be a smooth continuous shot or a scene transition. That's all for today. I hope this helps you out. Follow me to become someone who truly understands AI.